UEFA have officially launched a third tier European competition, and it's going to be called the UEFA Europa Conference League. And today we'll be explaining what it is, and I'll be giving my thoughts on whether it is a good idea or a bad idea. So let's get straight into this video. If you haven't already, please leave a like and subscribe and turn on the post notification bell, as we do all things Arsenal here. And this week we are previewing Benfica versus Arsenal, and then later on Manchester City versus Arsenal. The background music I'm using for this video, I'll leave the link down below, and the pictures I'm using for this, I'll leave it down below. It does go under the fair use law of YouTube as I'm talking over it, so please go check out those channels down below. So what is the UEFA Europa Conference League? So looking at what it is, it's a third tier UEFA competition. There are going to be 32 teams in the group stage, and the idea of it is it's going to be lower ranked associations of cup winners from lower ranked clubs that we'll look at in the coefficient rankings, which we'll look at later, and it gives them a chance to play in European competition. How will the Europa League and the Champions League, you know, change because of this? So the Champions League will remain as it is with 32 teams. The Europa League will be changed. Now it's going to go from 48 teams to 32 teams, which means, let's say in the Premier League, there's going to be less spaces for the Europa League, and they'll add another space for the UEFA Conference League. Now the Europa League, as I said, will go to 32 teams, and the new UEFA Europa Conference League will be 32 places as well. Now the Champions League, we're going to go over how it's going to work. So firstly, with the Champions League, we have the 8 group winners and the 8 runners-up. They all go to the round of 16, which is how it's always been. And then the third place teams, they don't go to the round of 32 of the Europa League. They go to something called the UEL playoffs. They're going to go to the playoffs. So that's something new. That's replacing the round of 32 of the Europa League. So now we're going to look at the Europa League. Just leave that playoff thing in mind. But the Europa League, the 8 group winners go straight to the round of 16. And the runners-up of the Europa League will go into the playoffs. So as you can imagine, what's going to happen is the 8 third place Champions League teams will be playing the 8 runners-up of the Europa League in what will be a playoffs, essentially similar to what the round of 32 is like, but it's going to be basically a playoffs, and then the winners will go into the round of 16. And then the Europa League third place teams will go into the Conference League knockout playoffs, and that's similar to what we'll look at next. So now we're going to look at the Europa Conference League. The eight group winners will go straight to the round of 16, and then as you can imagine, the 8 runners-up of the UEFA Europa Conference League will play the 8 third place teams of the UEFA Europa League in what will be the Conference League knockout playoffs, and the winner of those will play in the round of 16 of the UEFA Europa Conference League. Now we're going to look at what it is about. So the UEFA Europa Conference League, it's going to be comprised of cup winners from lower and average nations, 2nd to 4th from lower and average nations, 5th to 7th place from top nations, and UEFA Europa League qualifier losers, and even qualifier losers from the Champions League can go to the UEFA Conference League as well. So that's quite interesting. We're going to look at how it'll be comprised. So for the Champions League, it'll remain the same, as you can see on the screen now, and the qualifying and playoffs remains relatively same as well. But looking at the Europa League, it will be changed a bit, because obviously with the lower teams. So in terms of the associations, we'll look at the coefficients in a bit, but 1 to 4, which obviously includes the Premier League, the 4 5th place teams. So it's going to be the 5th place teams only that go to the Europa League. And as usual, if you do win the FA Cup, you also get in the place in the Europa League of the group stages. So that's how that's going to work. Now, in the UEFA Europa Conference League, no one gets straight into the group stage. You all have to go through the playoffs. So for the group stages, only the 10 teams from the Europa League playoff losers go straight into the group stages. The rest of them have to go through the qualifying and playoff rounds. And that will obviously be from the lower ranked countries, the 40 cup winners, from the 16 to 55 ranked countries. And then it will be, if you look at associations 1 and 4, which includes the Premier League, the 4th, 6th place teams will go straight in to that round. And they have to go through the playoffs as well. So it's not easy, but you know, it's gonna have to be like that. And if you win the UEFA Europa Conference League, you have a place straight into the Europa League group stages as well. So the whole point of this essentially is to give, you know, credit to lower teams, like, you know, island teams or maybe some other random teams. So if you didn't think Farmer If you didn't think the Europa League was a farmers league, if you thought that was a farmers league, this is going to be even more of a farmers league. Now, in terms of, you know, I'm going to look at Arsenal, for example. If we do make it into 6th or 7th, we could make UEFA Europa Conference League. Personally, I probably wouldn't want that because we're going to be playing bang average farmers. But again, it's a competition we'll probably be able to win with the amount of low quality in that league. Now, my thoughts on it now, we're into 5 minutes, so we're going to give my thoughts on this league. Now, my thoughts are, it's a good idea for the lower ranked countries in terms of a third tier European competition where, you know, you're not going to get much, you know, you're not going to get loads of, you know, Europa League action, even though if you do get it, you're not really going to do well in it. Looking at the UEFA country coefficients, you can just see them there. 1-4 is obviously Spain, England, Italy, Germany, and then, you know, France is 5th. So, you know, you can see it all there. I'm not going to bother going through all that right now, but yeah, that's how it's going to work. And then you can compare that to the earlier picture I put on how the group stages and qualifying and playoff rounds are going to work. But I think for bigger clubs as well, it's a good opportunity to win a European competition, like teams like, for example, Everton or Leicester or even Arsenal, to win a European competition. It's not a bad idea. And then if you win the competition, you go into the Europa League. You win the Europa League, you go into Champions League. So it's a good build-up thing. Negatives of this are, it's another competition, which means it's going to add stress to teams like maybe Arsenal, who want to focus on the Premier League but are going to having to play in this competition as well. Yes, you can obviously rotate the youth players, which is obviously a bonus, but it's just another competition. I think in some aspects it looks like a money-making scam again, but again, it looks like a good idea on the whole for me, and it's a good idea for the lower ranked countries, the lower ranked teams, to get a grip on this sort of competition, European competition, and play against bigger sides, earn a bit of money so they can climb their way up the ladder and give them more of an opportunity. And I don't think that's a bad idea at all. Leave me your thoughts in the comment section down below. Do you think this UEFA Europa Conference League is a good idea? Check the links down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. See you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.